Hi everybody. Today we continue with how to define classes, constructor, and functions or methods in C# class. So here we have this function main, and we have the my app is namespace, and we create a new file by press Ctrl N to create a new file. We create an empty class, so it is named bankaccount.C#. So here inside this class, we use a system and import to the namespace my app. So this is a constructor. The constructor is called when initializing an object. The name of the constructor is the same with the class name. So we have some of the property in this class. Firstly, we have account number. And the account number is read only because it only has a getter. It means that you cannot set the account number to a number, a specified number. So it is get or getter or read only. Read only means you cannot set the value. Owner is the owner name. The owner name, you can read write the value because it has getter and setter. Getter and setter are available, so you can read and write this value. So what about this? We also have balance. Balance is a decimal. Decimal is a number like integer, but it is used for money, so for defining money, for calculation of money. And balance is a remain money in your bank account. It means that your remain money in your account. Yes, you can use this to buy something. So we have a method or a function name deposit. And in C#, the function name of a class or the method we have the uppercase in the first character. The input argument here, we have amount or the amount of money, and the date. It means that the date to send money to your account, and the note means the description. So you can add money to your account at a time and with a specific description. So you can also withdraw or get money from your account to buy something. For example, you want to buy a car, you want to buy a laptop or computer. So it is withdraw. Withdrawal means that you get money from your account to buy something. And so the constructor has three arguments. Two arguments. You can set the owner to this owner, to the input parameter of owner, because it is it can read and write values, so you can set the owner. You can also set the account number. For example, the account number you get from here to generate from a function. You define a function to generate a private method to generate the number, the account number. So it is a long. A long, it means a very large number of integer. So it is private, so it can be called only inside this class. You cast this value now to the date time offset, and you convert this to the millisecond. It is the current time in millisecond to unit time millisecond. You can convert this time to millisecond, so you can save the unique value, for the account, for the account number. So you can call this this dot generate or without this, it is okay. So the account number is automatically generate one time in the constructor. It can only generate one time in the constructor and cannot be changed you cannot return outside this class, and you display to the console with right line with the return character at the end, and use the interpolate string. You show to this object initialize with the value. So the value of the object here is this dot account number and this dot balance and owner, etc. You can display the detail object in the form of string. You concatenate the string by line you using the interpolated strings. So we have balance, you have owner, you can show multiple value here inside this. So you remember to add the dollar sign and you run in the terminal.net run. After pressing .NET run, you see that the bank account has not been created. And why? Because we do not call this in the main function. So you must use it in the main function to initialize this object. So in the main function, you define an object account is equal to bank account, initialize bank account with the name and the initial balance. So the constructor is called here in new. When you call new, it will be called the constructor. Okay, so you can console log to the output here, account has been created. Okay, and it is the initial balance or the money money amount at the initial value. Yes, you can set the initial balance to the existing balance, and it is sometime depending on the bank, it require you to have at least one a specific value, a minimum value for initializing. So here we have the account number is it is a long, and you can add slash n for return, enter or return mean slash n or enter slash n or enter. Yes, so you see that each line has enter, so line by line you can see the detail on parameter would be display line. Okay, this is the end of my lesson today about how to define class and method function constructor in C#. Thank you so much for watching.